I think the biggest takeaway could be found in the audience rather than the panelists. The panelists were excellent, but the audience was really hungry for guidance on business virtue, where to find it, how to practice it, and how to deal with those tricky issues of situational ethics. I think you got two kinds of situations: people who were working in the trenches who felt that they needed they needed to somehow offset the questionable practices of the people who were their bosses, plus people who were bosses who wanted to take these ideas to their workplaces and to their companies.
Yeah, I think the financial crisis that occurred a number of years ago, the corporate scandals that have occurred, have just created the conditions for a greater degree of interest in society to have our organizational leaders be concerned with ethics and with virtue and greater corporate social responsibility.
I think the real takeaway from this excellent breakfast discussion is that character counts when you're building a corporate culture. That companies that can actually engage with their employees, retain their employees, empower their employees around the values and the virtues that the company extols are much more likely over the long run to be successful.
A takeaway is that virtues can be developed, and that in order to develop them, we need to understand how they manifest behaviorally. What do they look like? How do we make those virtues concrete so that they can be understood more broadly throughout the workplace? I think we've also underscored that virtues don't work at cross purposes with economic well-being of an organization. That virtues can actually nourish the economic well-being as well as the social and psychological well-being of employees. That the two come together, that one is not the trade-off for the other. This relates to my research in as much as my doctoral students and I are looking to empirically establish these relationships to show that leadership as expressed through virtues is manifested in higher performance and citizenship behavior and the well-being of the employees and the economic well-being of the organization.